What I would like to do in this video is explore the connection between the binary number system, which is clearly, or we've already talked about it, is base 2, and explore the connection between that and the hexadecimal number system, which is base 16. And the reason why this is interesting is because 16 is a power of 2. And so what we'll see is you can almost view the hexadecimal number system as almost a condensed representation of the binary number system. And this is actually why you will actually, we've already talked about the binary system is used extensively in computer science and even in computer engineering. It's the underlying things that are happening, or it's the representation used when we're talking about logic gates and transistors and things like that. But hexadecimal also shows up a lot because it is kind of a condensed representation of base 2. So what do I mean by that? So let's write out an arbitrary number in base 2. So let's say I have 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. So this right over here is in binary, and I can even write in parentheses that this is a binary representation. And I want to convert this to its hexadecimal representation. And I encourage you to pause the video and try it out on your own. And I'll give you a clue on how you can think about converting directly from base 2 to base 16. Think about what over here is in the 16's place and what is the 256 place over here. And then that might help you convert directly. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it. And the really fun thing about converting between base 2 and base 16 is you don't have to, well, for any bases, you really don't have to go through base 10. But these in particular, it's especially easy to go convert between these two bases. And the realization that you have to make is, well, what are the powers, which places here are powers of 16? So this right over here, that is the ones place. So one way to think about it is all of this is going to tell you how many ones we have. Ones, twos, fours, and eights, but another way to think about it is this is a count of ones all the way up to a potential of 15 ones. So this can count, so this is going to be between 0 and I'm going to write it down. Actually, let me write it down in base 16. It's going to be between 0 and F. It's going to be between 0 and 15. So it's a kind of a count of the number of ones, I guess you could say. Then this is the 16's place. Let me do that in a different color. This right over here is the 16's place. And you can have between 0 and 15 16's. So this is also going to be between 0 and F when you look at this four-digit binary number. So once again, this whole thing right over here is essentially going to tell you how many 16's you have. This whole thing is going to tell you how many 1's you have. And then the next four, and we could keep going, although there's only one place here, we could go, this right over here is the 256's place. And so this is going to be this next four digits. We only have one right over here, but 1, 2, 3, and then the fourth one. This is also going to be between 0 and 15 256's. So hopefully that helps you a little bit. Actually, if this was a clue, I encourage you to pause the video again and see if you can represent this in hexadecimal. So let's try to work this thing together. So how many ones do we have? So what number is this? These four digits right over here. This is 8 plus 4 plus 2. So 8 plus 4 is 12 plus 2 is 14. So this right over here is 14. How do we represent that in hexadecimal? Well, 14 is 1 less than 15. So it's going to be E. So this is going to be E. This is E. E is our hexadecimal representation of the number 14. Comes right before our representation of the number 15, F. All right, now how many 16's do we have? Let's see, I have no 8's, I have a 4, and I have a 2. So we're going to have 6 16's. So we're going to have 6 16's. And then how many 256's do I have? Well, I only have 1 256. 1 256. So this number in hexadecimal, and now I could write that, this is in hexadecimal right over here, is 16E. 16E. And I guess you could maybe call this 256E 14. I probably have to come up with a better way of reading these hexadecimal numbers. And if you're curious what number this is, because we didn't have to go through decimal, just so that you can comprehend it in the number system that you're used to operating in, one that's based off of the number of fingers you have, feel free to do so.